Today we're reading story 117 from the Gospel Story Bible by Marty Machowski. Today's story is The Resurrection. It's on page 235 and it's found in Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. These four Gospels are found in the New Testament. Here's the picture. The Resurrection. Jesus was dead and buried in a tomb. But that wasn't enough for the Pharisees and chief priests. They went back to Pilate and said, "This man was a fake. When he was still alive, he told people he would rise from the dead after 3 days. If his disciples get into his tomb and steal his body, they will tell everyone that Jesus has risen from the dead. You have to keep that from happening." So Pilate sent some soldiers to make sure the tomb was closed up so no one could get in. While the religious leaders watched, they put a Roman seal on the stone that closed up the tomb and posted soldiers to guard it. It was early in the morning, the third day after Jesus died. Some women who loved Jesus were taking spices to the tomb to anoint his body. On their way, they asked each other, "Who will roll the stone away for us so that we can get into the tomb?" But they didn't have to worry, for moments earlier, while the guards stood watch, two angels came down from heaven. Their bodies shined like lightning, and their clothes were as white as snow. The guards were so afraid that they were shaking. They fell down on the ground as though they were dead. One angel rolled back the stone and sat on it, as a great earthquake shook the ground. Soon the women arrived and saw the angels with the stone rolled away. What had happened? One angel said to the woman, "Don't be afraid. I know that you seek Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here, for he has risen just as he said. Come, see the place where he lay." Then the angels instructed the women to tell his disciples that Jesus would meet them in Galilee. When the women went into the tomb, Jesus' body was gone. Quickly, they ran to tell the disciples, but the disciples found their story hard to believe. Peter and John ran to the tomb to see for themselves. They went inside and saw Jesus' grave clothes lying there. But Jesus himself was gone. That's when they believed what the women had told them. After the disciples went home, Mary Magdalene, one of the women, stayed outside the tomb crying. Two angels came to her and asked, "Why are you crying?" "Someone has taken my Lord away," Mary said, "and I don't know where they have laid him." She had taken the disciples the message, but she hadn't understood it herself. Then Mary turned and noticed a third man standing there. She thought he was the gardener, but then he called her name, Mary. At once she knew it was the Lord Jesus. She fell at his feet and worshiped him. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, 'I am ascending to my Father and to your Father, to my God and your God.'" So Mary returned to the disciples and told them she had seen the Lord. Did you know that Jesus' death and resurrection is the most important part of the whole Bible? Every story in the Bible that took place before Jesus looks forward to his death and resurrection. Every story after Jesus' death and resurrection looks back upon those days to celebrate the good news of the gospel. The Apostle Paul said the resurrection is so important that we are lost without it. What do you see going on in the picture? What happened to the soldiers who had been guarding the tomb? Why is Jesus' resurrection so important? Tune into our next video to learn more about God's big story. If you're following along at home in your Old Story New devotional, we're on week 39, and on Monday, you can start on day 1.